Here you see a normal domestic sewing machine with a normal timing of the feed dog. We start with the needle comes up and then the feed dog lifts the fabric and start to move it. And now the needle goes down again, and now the point of the needle hits the fabric, and when we go further, you see that actually the feed dogs did not finish the movement before the needle hit, and therefore, and this last movement here, we actually have got the needle bended. And now there is a big risk that the needle will hit the needle plate and the machine will stop because of that. And you can get damage of the needle and the needle plate. So that's bad, and that's because of the normal timing of these machines are made so that you actually cannot have a thick fabric like this of about 7 millimeter. This is too thick for these kinds of machines with the timing they got. Some of the machines can have this timing of the feed dog changed. This machine can. This is a 66K, and I got a Singer 237. This can definitely not be changed. And then I got a Singer 201, and there the timing of the feed dogs can be changed too. I made a measurement on how the feed dogs move on my Singer 201. You can see that in this diagram, the movement of the feed dog is represented by blue line. Left-right is the forward-backwards movement. The up-down on this diagram is also up-down of the feed dogs. And the red line represents the needle plate. There is some small blue dots. They represent turn of the hand wheel by 10 degrees. There's some black marks that say where the needle is and where the take-up lever is, and so on, to give an idea what is happening. I'll just make a note on how I measured this. I used this protractor printed on a piece of paper, and I glued that temporarily to the hand wheel so I could measure the angle of the hand wheel. And then I put on this piece of wood onto the feed dogs, and in this way I could measure the height of the feed dog. And for that I used this vernier caliper. It is kind of strange that the timing of the feed dogs is like that. I tested this diagram not exactly with measurements, but on four other machines, and they are basically made in the same way. When the needle is max position, the feed dogs just started to move fabric. I don't know why it is so. I hope one engineer that knows something about sewing machines can tell me someday why it is like that. But now I try to change it. If you see this diagram, if we move the timing of the feed dog forward about 30 degrees, the max needle position would be when the feed dogs have moved about halfway. And then the feed dog movement should have finished when the needle starts to hit the fabric. The timing of the feed dogs is controlled by the mechanism you see here. You got the two eccentrics on the main shaft, and you got the lock pinol screw that is set into this groove you see in the main axle. That's a normal thing, but I've changed that. So now you can see that I turn this piece of metal with eccentrics on a bit forward. So now the lock screw is pressing not in the groove, but besides the groove. And it changed the timing about 30 degrees for the feed dogs. And now we'll go back and look how this is. I'll just say that it solved the problem. The machine have no problem in sewing thick materials. I've tried a bit with the sewing machine now and I can't find any problems with this advanced in timing. This shows the feed dog timing when it has been advanced about 30 degrees. And we start here with the needle is leaving the fabric here and it is not moved by the feed dogs. Now the feed dogs race and now it starts to move and then the needle starts to descend again and I don't move anymore and now the needle hits the fabric and it is not moved anymore and there's no problem.